GMO, which stands for genetically modified organism. Let's break it down word by word. Genetically refers to genes. Genes are made up of DNA, which is a set of instructions for how cells grow and develop. Second is modified. This implies that some tweak or change has been made. Lastly, we have the word organism. When it comes to GMOs, many people only think of crops. Yet, an organism isn't just a plant. It refers to all living things, including bacteria and fungi. Examples of genetically modified varieties are flava, sava, tomatoes. It is the first commercially grown genetically modified food to be granted a license for human consumption. It is modified by adding an antisense gene to slow down the ripening process, thus preventing it from softening. Antisense gene interferes with the production of enzyme, polygalacturonase. This enzyme normally degrades pectin in the cell wall and results in the softening of fruit, which makes them more susceptible to being damaged by fungal infections. The next one is BT maize. Maize plant was modified with genes of Bacterium bacillus thuringiensis to synthesize delta protein, which is responsible for resistance against insects. As the insect eats the kernel, delta protein is activated in the gut that results in the paralysis of the digestive system of the insect. The insect stops eating within a few hours and eventually starves. Next, we will talk about the pros and cons of genetically modified organisms. One of its advantages is stronger crops. One of the main advantages of GM technology is that crops can be engineered to withstand weather extremes. This means that there will be a good quality and sufficient yields even under poor or severe weather conditions. As populations across the world grow and more land is being utilized, farmers are pushed to grow crops in locations that are regionally not suitable. Just think of the technology as a vaccine for the species, except that it is encoded into their genes rather than being shot into their immune system. The next one is that it is easier to transport. Because GMOs have a prolonged shelf life, it is easier to transport them greater distances. This improvement makes it possible to take excess food products from one community and deliver it to another that may be experiencing a food shortage. GMO food gives us the opportunity to limit food waste, especially in the developing world, so that hunger can be reduced and potentially eliminated. Now let's move on to the disadvantages of genetically modified foods. The first one is allergic reactions. In humans, the number one most common side effect of eating GM food is allergic reaction. This happens when a certain allergen present in the GM crop enters the body and stimulates an immune response. Genetically modified foods are created by inserting foreign genes into an organism. This process is considered to have adverse effects on humans because these inserted genes may carry along with them specific allergens that trigger such an immune response. In addition, there is also the fear that new allergies could happen because of the mixing of genes from two organisms. And because some inserted genes come from bacteria and viruses, the possibility of transfer of disease is there too. The next one is lower level of biodiversity. One potential drawback of this technology is that some organisms in the ecosystem could be harmed, which in turn could lead to a lower level of biodiversity. When we remove a certain pest that is harmful to crops, we could also be removing a food source for a certain species. In addition, genetically modified crops could prove toxic to some organisms, which can reduce their number or have them go extinct. One of the controversies about GMO is that the public is questioning their safety and wanting the products labeled as genetically modified. There are other concerns from some of the scientific world and some government officials and organizations such as the Food and Agricultural Organization or FAO that questions whether adequate research has been done to qualify GMOs as safe for long-term use. One of the particular concerns are the allergenic properties a GMO may impart. Possible transfer effects of antibiotic resistance, given that antibiotic resistant marker genes are used for many GMOs. The expression of previously unexpected traits and the drift of pollen from genetically modified crops. It has also been noted that the laws and regulations governing the biotechnology world are outdated, are not comprehensive, and span too many agencies.